scandal, it was a scandal. To know him, this is important. Why? Because it is possible to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the dream. Okay, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Shaytan la yatamathal fi bi. The Shaytan cannot imitate my picture in the dream. Okay, but many people claim that we saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our dreams. But when you ask them, okay, describe, they say, I saw, old man, his beard was white, he was tall. This is totally wrong. Totally wrong. So inshallah, I will mention a few points about the shape and the description of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was rab'ah, that means he was not tall and he was not short. He was in between, little bit tall. His skin was white, tends to the red color, alayhi salatu wasalam. His hair was not straight and was not curly, it was in between, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes his hair was up to the ears, and sometimes up to the elbow. And of course, when he goes to Hajj or Umrah, he will shave his hair. His feet and hands relatively thick, huge. And this is nice in the man. But Anas said it was softer than the silk. When you shake hands with him, it is softer than the milk. The big joints relatively were big, like the elbow and the knees and the shoulders. There was hair from the neck to the navels, alayhi salatu wasalam. When he walks, he walks a little bit fast, alayhi salatu wasalam. He was not slow, and of course he's not running, but he used to walk a little bit fast, alayhi salatu wasalam. His mouth was big. And this is nice in the man, alayhi salatu wasalam. Ashkal al-aynayn, يعني there was in the white color of the eye, there is a little bit reddish color. طيب, manmus al-aqd, the heel of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was thin. And as we mentioned, the khutbah al-bala' al-azl, he said he was more beautiful, more handsome than the moon, alayhi salatu wasalam. His face was like the moon, circular. It was not like a sword. He looks like Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And there is the seal of prophethood on the back of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam under the left shoulder. It is like some companions describe this, the seal of prophethood. It is one of the signs that he is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. It is like the egg of a pigeon. And egg of the pigeon. Okay, like this size. And there is hair on this seal, alayhi salatu wasalam. Sometimes his hair is long. We mentioned, up to the shoulder or up to the ear. And sometimes he will make them like plexus, like the woman now. But what this was common before in the Quraysh. Also, he likes to comb his hair. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha used to comb the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The companions counted how many white hair. Anas counted 20. You'll find maybe some of the companions said 14. Why? Because at some time it was 14, but later there were more. Or maybe he did not count exactly. He did not have the chance to count exactly. But Anas told us 20, and not more than 20. He likes to wear the al-qamis. There is kind of dress called the qamis. Qamis is like the dishdash, like the Kuwaiti style or the Gulf style. Okay, but shorter, up to the mid of his leg, alayhi salatu wassalam. When he is, as you mentioned, the khutbah, is sweating like, not like, it is a perfume, alayhi salatu wassalam. The sweat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is perfume. He likes to open his buttons. He likes to keep the buttons open, alayhi salatu wassalam. He dressed the red color. He dressed red color, alayhi salatu wasalam, plain red color. Also, he used to wear the leather sock. The leather sock, it is called khuf, and to wipe on it for the wudu. And also, he prayed with this leather socks, alayhi salatu wasalam. Also, he used to wear a ring. At the beginning, it was gold, but later it became forbidden, and he threw it, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he started to wear a silver ring. And there was, what was written? It was written, Muhammad Rasulullah. It was written, Muhammad Rasulullah. And some good sons will say, it is the opposite. Allah Rasul Muhammad, the order. But there is no proof for this. The proof is Muhammad Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then subhanAllah, his ring went to Abu Bakr, then after Abu Bakr to Umar, then after Umar to Uthman. And subhanAllah, at the time of Uthman, they lost the ring of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It was with the slave of the helper assistant from Uthman, or the guardian of the ring of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. His name was Mu'ayqi. And it went inside a well called Aris, fi bi'ri Aris. And he wore the ring in the right hand and the left hand, alayhi salatu wasalam. When he goes to the battle, when he fights the kuffar with the companions, he used to wear the helmet and the shield for the fighter, alayhi salatu wasalam. When he sits for the food, as we mentioned the khutbah, he sits like the slave. Like the slave, yani, it sits like the, between the two sujood, this way. He used to sit on the heels of his leg. Why? Because you will not feel comfortable by this way. So it means he will not stay long time for the food. He will not stay for long time for the food, and he used to eat little, alayhi salatu wasalam, if there is food, because most of the time there is no food. Only it is water and dates, and sometimes even there is no dates. You know, when a poor lady came to the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam with two daughters, she asked Aisha, I need something. Aisha gave this lady only three pieces. She asked, oh, I have only three pieces of dates. And she gave this woman gave the two daughters, one, and the third one for herself. SubhanAllah, as usual, the kids eat quickly. So they ate the dates quickly, and they start asking the mother, please. So subhanAllah, the mother and the nurse of the mother, she split her date into two pieces. Brothers and sisters, can you imagine that situation? They are poor. I mean, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Aisha, no food in sight. And she gave what she has, Aisha. She gave the three pieces of dates. And subhanAllah, these poor people, this mother, also gave the daughters this date into two pieces, alayhi salatu wasalam. Yes, he was humble, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mutawadhu, but he has his prestige, alayhi salatu wasalam. When you see him, you respect him, alayhi salatu wasalam. So, we have a lot about the description of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Maybe I can mention this in several khutbah. Jazakumullah khair, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.